In the United States, each person on hemodialysis is hospitalized an average of 2 times a year. Approximately 1 in 10 of those hospitalizations is the result of preventable vascular access infections. Infections in dialysis patients pose serious health risks and can have lasting repercussions on patients' lives. Take John, for example. John has been on dialysis for 6 years. Most of that time was without complications, but there was one event, a vascular access infection, that had the potential to change everything. John went in for his dialysis treatment as usual, but this time, the tech initiating dialysis had trouble palpating John's fistula. Instead of asking for assistance, the tech took off her glove and palpated the site with a bare hand to feel the access site better. The tech should have re-cleaned the site before initiating dialysis, but instead, she inserted the needle without repeating the disinfection step. This seemingly small breach in protocol set off a domino effect of problems for John. John developed a fever and was treated with antibiotics. The fever worsened, and John ended up in the hospital for 4 days. John was on antibiotics for 10 weeks and underwent multiple procedures to treat the infection of his access and make sure the infection didn't spread to his heart valves. Fortunately, he recovered without the serious long-term consequences that might have occurred. But still, for John, dealing with the infection was like a prolonged nightmare. Infections like John's are serious but preventable. Let's explore what you can do to keep your patients safe and protected from infection. First, it's critical that technicians and other staff follow all recommended safety precautions. Don't hesitate to support each other, and especially the patients, by speaking up when you notice coworkers not following the correct procedures. Many facilities continually educate staff on proper care using videos, in-house learning sessions, or participation in educational programs. But how can you make sure the person at the center of this activity, the patient, be included in efforts to prevent infections? Not all patients can or want to be involved in infection prevention, but it's important to ask and include those who are interested. Patients bring unique perspectives and additional eyes and ears to your team. Start by being transparent in your infection prevention efforts. Explain to patients what you do to keep them safe from infections. You and other staff work really hard behind the scenes to keep patients safe, but they may not know it. To draw attention to your goal of patient safety, celebrate being infection-free by posting a continually updated sign in a place easily seen by both patients and staff. When it's possible, you should try to replace a patient's catheter with a permanent access, like a fistula or graft. These are much safer options than a catheter. You and other staff should celebrate when a patient has their catheter removed and replaced by a permanent access. This is a significant preventive action that will help avoid infection. To help keep patients involved in infection control, some facilities ask patients to complete monthly checklists as part of the facility's quality improvement process. Others have invited patients to join their quality assurance performance improvement teams. Whatever the protocol is at your facility, all care teams should encourage patients to speak up when they feel uncomfortable or unsure about processes or cleanliness, especially those during initiation and termination of a dialysis session. Patients may not know the proper protocol. When they do, they are better equipped to voice concern when steps are skipped or modified. Walk patients through the dialysis process step by step so they understand it. You may need to do this multiple times. You and all staff should practice good hand hygiene. Wash your hands and change your gloves each time before touching patients, before beginning a clean or aseptic procedure, after exposure to body fluids, and after touching patients or their surroundings, like the dialysis machine or chair. Let patients know when you perform hand hygiene and why. Most importantly, empower patients to take an active role in their care, inside and outside the facility. Take the time to talk to patients about what they can do outside of the facility to prevent infections. Show them the proper care for their catheter or permanent access. Show them how to wash their hands regularly with soap and water, and encourage them to alert their care team if they notice any redness, swelling, or discharge at the access site. Preventing infections requires both patients and facility staff working closely together. It is possible and worth it